Alright, class.
Yep.
I'm Professor Jiminy Brimson, and this is Melons 101. Alright. What is a melon?
A large round fruit.
Alright, so he's got the basics down.
What do we use melons for?
To keep hydrated.
Do you want to teach the class?
You asked me a question.
Do you want to get up here and take the class?
No.
Well, stop being such a smart ass.
Okay.
What are some kinds of melons?
I don't know.
We got watermelon, we got rock melon, we got pumpkin sorta, patty melons, we got cucumber, I'm gonna say that's a melon. Anthony Fantano legally identifies as a melon.
Are you sure?
Don't argue with melon facts. I'm Australia's leading melanologist.
Yeah, but...
I'm gonna fail you if you don't shut your mouth. Do you know how dumb that'll make you look? What kind of kid fails melon class?
Okay.
Alright, time for show and tell. I asked you to bring something in related to the class.
Oh yeah, we have to do it outside. For today's show and tell for melon class, I brought a big melon.
What the f***? He's killing it.
This is my dad's melon. He let me borrow it for the day.
I remember him. Your father was our top melon student at just age 12. His legend lives on to this day.
So obviously, I could never live up to my dad's legacy.
Yeah, obviously.
But I'm trying my best to follow in my dad's melon footsteps.
Tell me something about this melon, Lachlan.
The melon is round and large and is a fruit.
How did you get so far ahead?
This melon is the only one we have.
Treat it carefully.
We worked very hard to purchase.
What the f***?
I'm gonna be in a lot of trouble.
What the f***? That's like killing a baby in baby class.
Oh no.
Alright, what we're gonna do is we're gonna clean this up and tell no one.
What about my father?
We're gonna get you another melon.
Another melon?
Another melon.
From where?
We're gonna steal one from the melon store.
Oh no.
Armed robbery.
That's where Melanie works.
We'll sacrifice her.
She's my crush.
Her blood will spill for melon.
It'll be a melon heist.
That's right, Lachlan, a melon heist.
Oh.
Just you and me. Jiminy Brimson and Landon.
It's Lachlan.
Just me and you, teacher and student, in this together. Unlikely team. Two lone wolves become one bigger wolf.
I don't think we have to.
We strike at midnight. This is happening.
What are the logistics?
Don't worry about the logistics.
It's going to be a logistical nightmare.
It's not going to be a logistical nightmare.
Oh, no.
We'll steal the melons, Lyndon.
Oh.
We'll steal them.
Where is he?
Alright, landmine, it's heisting time.
We're really gonna go through with the melon heist?
Of course we are. How else are we gonna replace your melon?
Well, we could buy a new melon.
Don't be ridiculous, no one's got that kind of money.
Well, how are we gonna steal the melon?
With stabbing.
With what?
Stabbing.
Yeah, but what do you mean?
Stab them. With these knives.
Well, can't we shoot them?
How good can you aim a gun, Leroy?
Well, fairly poorly, because I have no experience with firearms.
You think I have? I'm a professor of melons. Our best bet is stabbing.
Well, those are kitchen knives.
What?
Well, they aren't even the best knives to use for stabbing.
How much do you know about stabbing?
I'm just saying you could... Well, that's a butter knife, and that's... You got a cheese knife there.
You know what? I'm hearing a lot of negativity coming from your way. I'm beginning to think you don't even want to be involved in this.
I don't. How many times do I have to tell you I don't want to be involved?
Well, it's too late. We're too deep now.
No, we aren't. We could just not commit the melon heist.
It's too late. I've already called the police and told them there'll be a fruit-related robbery today.
Well, why would you do that?
To give us a bit of danger, you know? A bit of fire under our asses. Bit of heat under our tails.
That's a terrible idea. That's the worst idea.
I got a worse idea.
There is no worse idea than that.
So I was thinking we stab ourselves, you know, just lightly, just so we're bleeding a little bit through the heist. Just so we know, you know, the clock's ticking.
That was a worse idea.
I'm good.
F*** this, I'm out.
I've actually already reported you for the crime.
You've what?
I reported you for the crime, so you can't back out.
That doesn't make any sense.
Well, if you don't commit the heist, then they're going to think it was you anyway. And if you go home, they'll be waiting there to arrest you.
Well, now we're going to be on the run. We're going to be in so much more trouble than just breaking my dad's melon.
I understand things have escalated, but this is our life now, Lumbago.
This doesn't even solve my initial problem. It only makes it worse.
What problem?
I broke my dad's melon.
Oh, what the fuck? I'd full forgotten about that. I've gotten very carried away.
Oh, what a mess we've got ourselves tangled in.
Well, we better get going.
All right, let's go fuck our lives up. Let me just make one call.
Sure thing, Larry.
Hey, Melanie. Don't come into work today.
Knives.
Check.
Robbing clothes.
Check.
Martial arts ability.
Judo chop.
There's no time to improve that.
Alright, so what's the plan?
Alright, so Melanie's Melons is just over that hill. We take the ute, commit the heist, and get out as quick as possible.
Yeah, but what if we...
If anything goes wrong, you grab that melon and you run.
Yeah, but what about...
Grab that melon and you get out of here.
Yeah, but what happens...
You don't look back! Grab that melon and get out of here, Lancelot! You get out of here! Have you got that?
Yeah.
Alright. No need to dilly or dally. Let's get on with it.
What are you doing at my melon store?
We're here to take a melon.
Like hell you are.
We'll see about that. Get the melon and run! Get out of here!
What about you?
Forget about me!
What about Melanie?
Forget about Melanie!
I've always loved you!
But what about-
Run! Go!
right, sir. We've waited long enough.
Please, just give me one more minute.
It's been 10 minutes since court was in session, and there's absolutely no sign of your representation.
Please, sir, I beg of you. I can't represent myself.
Nah, that's it. Without any lawyers, we're going to skip straight to the sentencing. Lachlan Fairbairn, I sentence you to...
Hold the sentencing!
Hold the sentencing!
What's this?
We are Chip and Randy Johnston.
And we are Lemoyne's attorneys.
Yes! Right, we demand you let Lyndon go immediately.
And what's your argument?
Landmine would like to plead insanity.
No, I wouldn't.
Yes, he would. Landmine, shut the fuck up. We're trying to get you away with a heist.
Was that an admission of guilt?
No, and he's insane. I'm not insane. That's exactly what an insane person would say. See, Judge? He's losing it. Judge?
Yes, Lemon?
You look a hell of a lot like the undercover cop that arrested me.
You mean the undercover cop that was pretending to be Melanie for 14 years?
Yes, you appear completely identical to that undercover cop.
That wasn't me, that was my chief constable, Greg. I've been sitting here this whole time.
Oh, what the fuck?
You're probably not going to hear from me again, though. There's too many characters already.
Wait, so are you Melanie, or did you take Melanie's identity?
No. There was no Melanie, only me, Greg. I was just pretending to be Melanie for all these years.
Wait, so you're telling me that since middle school, I've had a crush on an adult police constable.
It was the wig, you see.
It does bring out your eyes. Excuse me, we have a serious crime to get you away with. If in fact you did commit it, which you didn't.
Prove it then. Prove that he didn't steal the melon.
Now, according to Peruvian law...
We are not in the country of Peru.
I got this. Linston, where were you on the day of the incident?
I was in...
Peru.
You were not in Peru. You were arrested at the scene of the crime.
Can we prove he wasn't in Peru on the day in question?
Yes!
I arrested him at the melon store.
We didn't want to have to do this.
Do what?
Jiminy, come on in. It is I, Jiminy.
Jiminy!
Yes, Logland. I'm not dead.
I can't believe it! I can't believe you're not dead!
Not only am I not dead, I have specific evidence that pertains to this exact case.
What's the evidence?
I've got it here on my iPhone.
Airdrop that to me, actually.
Oh yeah, sure, here you go. Here I have a photo of Landmine in Peru. Clearly dated April 10th, the exact day of the melon heist.
Judge, this is ridiculous.
So obviously this is a photo of Lanson in Peru on the day of the event.
Yes, which directly disproves Greg's statement about apprehending London on that day.
I brought him in on that day. He's right there, can't you see? Greg, I think we've all heard enough. Now, Lachlan, I don't think I could honestly convict you based on the evidence here that you were in Peru on the day of the crime.
Yes!
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 Lachlan, Jiminy, Chip, Randy, today you've pulled off one of the most spectacular legal defences that I've ever seen.
We did it, boys.
Who would have thought a motley crew of misfits, nobodies and losers could walk into a courtroom like that and turn an almost certain conviction around in a matter of seconds?
Yes!
Yes!
Ah! Court dismissed, you scallywags. Get out of here.
What about Jiminy? If he's alive, he should be put on trial too. He should be taken to the prosecutor. He should be put in the slammer.
Get the hell out of here, you lot. Let's just forget about this whole shebang, eh?
Well, this makes absolutely no sense.
Oh, and Greg, you'll be facing 25 to life for giving false testimony about Lachlan.
What? Suck it, bitch. Suck balls, you loser.
Yeah, you absolute loser. Suck it.